So it's a very warm welcome to Kelly's Pub in El Cajon for the final match of the season of the BCA San Diego Metro 8-Ball Pool League. It's week 38. It's taken us almost 9 months to get this far. And tonight we see home team Kelly's 2, otherwise known as It's COMPLIC8TED, playing visitors on Q3, otherwise known as Double Snap. And it's Jesse from Double Snap at the table. He's taking the strike balls. And he's in good shape here. He's going to try and play forward for the 13. That's not quite worked out, so he may choose to develop these two safe balls on the long rail at the left, since they didn't either have pockets. Berna's trying to get that 2 through. She's actually taken the pocket. Now, Jesse could have played thin off that ball on the left the night there and actually knocked the 2 in, so I think he's missed a trick there. Berna pushing the 3 down onto the 7, taking another pocket. Shrewd play. So he's going to follow forward here, try and get shape on that 9 into that top left-hand pocket. Looks like it'll squeeze in from my angle. He's caught the 2 with it first, so setting up Berna here. She's going to take this 5 ball and now play the 1. Disturb the 3, so that's got a last remaining safe ball out in the open. So just needs to watch out here. Playing the 10 down onto the 9. Now a deadweight shot to put the 2 ball in and leave the 9 over the pocket would be good. He played a bit too hard and not quite the right line, so hence he followed forward and went in off. Or scratched, as you say here in the US. He's got another chance straight back though, so push this 11, follow forward, shape on the 10. He didn't quite play it dead straight, hence cannon the 4. Now his hook needs to kick. That's a miss, so ball in hand for Berna. Nice chance for it to try and get a few balls in. Combination there. 6 over the pocket, now play the 6. Plus finished awkward on the 3, so looks like a length of the table combo is all she's got, a length of the table bank rather. And that's got to be a sellout, really. Jesse's going to follow forward here on this 10 ball. And a straightforward 8-2. Win the first rack and lead 1-0. And so, moving into rack 2, it's Riff Melancon to break the balls this time. His opponent from on cue is Brian Wroolie. Close to here, the Fargo ratings. Riff's is 541, Brian's 535, so he should have a good game here. Well, that certainly had a good look around before he decided to go in the pocket. Used all of the pocket there. So he's going to take the 13 on here. Looks like he's following forward. He had a bit of left spin up there as well. I think he's left, lost the cue ball slightly. He's got a thin cut to this top right, the right middle as you look at the table. Nicely controlled. Shape on the 14. Play this, bounce off the short rail. Come back towards the stripe just by the cue ball. Very good, delicately played, nice shot. Slightly hampered, tree topped over the 8, the 5, but it's quite close to the pocket, should make this. He's managed to draw back there. Fortunately, he's remained quite close to the side rail. He's actually joined by playing the cue ball out of the jaws of the pocket, so very difficult to get the cue ball down below the 8, which is where he needs it to be if he wants to make it, because it won't go anywhere in those top pockets. Yeah, and he's a bit disappointed, so he's going to have to try and play something inventive here. It's like a length of the table bank. He's going to come and kiss the cue ball, kiss the 1 ball. Yeah. A few shots later, he found himself hooked like this. He's doing a jump back shot. That was a nice jump, well controlled. Nearly got it in off the 6. So here's Riff's chance to make a few balls, make a game of this. Taking the 1 now. The 6 and 7 look like they're a combo, but the way he's played that, I think he's playing for the 5 first, and then maybe try and get behind those. He's gone below them. Oh, he's kissed the 6, so that's a scratch. And he looks up, he concedes the game there. He doesn't need Brian to knock that 8 ball in. So rack 3 is now Jeff Peckham from Kelly's, breaking the balls. Nice break there. Got a couple of solids in, I think. He's taking the song, he's taking the three here. He's got the one over the corner. He'll be taking that, and they're probably the five following this. Oh, he's just nudged up. It's 13 on 2-6 ball, so that makes it a little bit tricky. Oh, that's the 7, actually. He tried to disturb it now, so he didn't have much choice. So he's taking the 4. At end of inning, Wayne comes to the table. Wayne Crow from double snap. Lovely angle here. He could play this, try and flick out one of those two balls on that long rail. Perfect. Very nice shot indeed. Little draw here. Very delicate. And he's still got a problem with that 13, so he should have. I'd have considered trying to break it out at that point, but I think he's following forward on the 9 to leave himself the angle to break it out with the next shot. So this is the one, the 11 here. Needs to get a bit of luck here. Whenever you play a cannon, you do need a little bit of luck because things like that can happen. As you can see, he's full ball hooked. I'll try and kick this into the opposite side. Not a bad attempt, but Jeff's got his chance now. He really needs to take this. Quite tight, those side pockets, especially from that acute angle. So you would expect Wayne to finish these off, especially if that 8 passes, and it looks as though it does. So 8 ball here for 3-0 to double snap. Well played, Wayne. And rounding off the first round, his round is it's not the end of the round, is it? Still doing a third game. Yeah, there are. Oh, no, it is. It is the fourth. The scoreboard's catching up. Sorry about that, folks. Yeah, so basically, there are 4 players on each team. So there are 4 rounds of 4 games when everybody plays everybody, other than the order changes. So Mike here from Double Snap playing Rob Elliott from Kelly's. It's complicated. Ooh, he's overhit that. Lost the cue ball a little bit. Very thin on the 14. He's going to take the 9 here. Try and hold the cue ball. He's drifted past the 11. Got an awkward shot. All he can really do is try and cut this in the top left-hand pocket. Maybe play a bit of left-hand spin off that long rail. But he can get the spin in. That's kissed the 8 and left himself hooked behind the 5, I think. Tried a kick shot. No joy. So Rob has his chance now to strike back. He's cutting this one ball at the side. Nice shot there. And this ball's all in the open. Only the 3 is a bit tricky. Put a lot of inside spin on that. Maybe more than he wanted. He's gonna take the 3 ball now. Oh, that could be a sellout there. If Mike could drop this in the side, he'll have perfect shape on his last stripe, and the 8 is waiting after that. Stop shot. And here we go, folks. This is going to be 4-0. Yeah, that's the first round to double snap. And now it's the visitors breaking the balls this round, round 2. So Brian to begin. This time he's up against Berna. Well, the one tried to go in. 4 is trying as well, but nothing fell, so a dry break. Berna takes the stripes. Looks like the 10 ball next. Oh no, she's playing the 12 onto Brian's ball. That's a clever shot, actually, trying to clear the block pocket. All right, just chipping this one in the side. The 7 is going to take the 5 ball next, I think. Bit of bottom left hand English. So he's got a choice. He's got the 1. I think the this. I say 2 ball also goes. A nice shot. He's now back on the 1. Should be playing shape for the 6 in the bottom left. Oh, he's overscrewed that. So change of plan. playing the three. Is he playing off the right side of it? He is. Yeah, he's cleared that pocket again. Took a strategic shot on. So the 11 up the rail for Berna. That's a nice shot. He's got the 9 down here in this bottom left. Nicely rolled forward. Now the 15. The bottom right. I've lost the cue ball a little bit. So what's she going to play here? Well, it's a 3-ball combo to put Brian's ball in, but I think she may have sold out the game. 6 in the side, drawing onto the short rail. That's a lovely shot. Penny will be taking this in that bottom corner. Nice shot from Brian there. That's 5-0. Wayne Crow with the break against Riff Melancon. Couple of balls dropped. The 3 ball's going to dress up nicely over the corner. So I think he's going to take the solids here. A bit of draw on the left-hand side. What's he looking at there? Long shot in the corner pocket. Slightly hurried delivery there. Bit jerky. So Riff's at the table. Got his chance on the 11. Oh dear, it looks like it's contagious. Another miss. So Wayne doesn't need second invitations. He's going to push forward here. Looking at the 1 ball, I think. Oh, and another miss. Could be a little bit of nerves. Wayne is actually in running for 3rd place MVP. Last week we had a good win against Watts Shape. Now, Shaper had the 3rd place MVP in their team. That's Dodge Johnson. But as we won, then Wayne got 4 wins. He was able to draw level with Dodge on total wins, so it put him into joint 3rd spot for the MVP prize. So he's got that little bit of extra pressure tonight, thinking if he can win all his games, he might get the 3rd spot in the MVP. I think it's safe to say, it's a good hit on the 8, that MVP 1 and MVP 2 are both tied up. That's Robert Howell is the number 1 stick, and Lewis Abarca, he's number 2 MVP. Both of those players are from League Champions, Galleys 1, otherwise known as Goodfellas, who have sewn up the league with a couple of weeks to spare, actually. So Riff's back at the table, he's got his chance to steal now. He can make this. It looks like it passes the 8th. He can just do a little stunt shot. Beyond the 14, he can run out. Would he clip the 8? Oh dear. A reprieve for Wayne. Comes to the table with a thin 8. This for 6-0. That's the cue ball going. Oh, no legs on. Next up. It's Halty breaking the balls against Jeff Peckham. Okay, a solid forward in there. So he's got his choice, he's taking the stripes. Trot the cue ball back to the centre of the table. Looks like Shape on the 10. Maybe take the 13 after this. Oh, but he's drifted down the table, so. So what? You never really like taking these ones that are over the corner. They're tricky to control. Slightly over on that, so not an ideal angle. In a lot of inside on that. That did not work out. So he's having to jump here. That's a poor delivery indeed. So Jeff with ball in that. Clears his first problem. Now he's taking number 3. Nice shot. You can pop this 2 ball in and bounce out. Somewhere in the middle of the table, he'll be looking good. Excellent shot. Little draw now. Give him with a flexion ball. This is slightly thinner than he would have liked. Oh, he's lost the cue ball there. It's going to go behind the 9. And then his full ball hooked himself there. Jump cue is coming out. Oh my goodness, have you seen that? Well, that's actually a legal shot. He jumped completely over the 8, a couple of rails, knocked down the table at the 8. And the 8 hit a rail, so Pressure shot for Mike now. 11 in the bottom corner. Must make it. Nice. Nicely done. Looks like the 9. Follow forward. And a kiss on the 8. Oh, that's perfect. Probably play this with a bit of inside and play off one rail there. Play it down off the short rail. Check. There we go. Shape. It's always good if you can get nice shape on the money ball. This to 7-0. There we go. And next up now, this is the final wreck of round 2. Jesse Sturm breaking the balls against Rob Elliot. Stripes dropped in with the last turn of its rotation. He's taking the solids. The one ball goes in. 5 ball and his sights. Colliding into the 9. How's he finished here? He's pushing this up into the top corner. Oh, it's just about falling there. Generous pocket. Nice shot again. 3 ball next. Maybe try and disturb the 6. No joy. Got to bank it. May as well take it on now. Short. Yeah, is it the near draw there? Fortunate. So Rob with his chance. Nice step cut down the table. He's got shape on the 11 here. Drop this in. These two are sitting pretty. A little bit of... What's he doing there? He's taking the top off the 2. Could have been tempted to take the 9 with a little bit of draw. Then play the other one. We all see the game differently. He's got a thin cut here. Very nice. Ah, but this time he has lost the cue ball. Need to funnel all the way down, bounce off that rail and get up for those 2 balls in that top left there. But it was full attack mode. He played the combo bank shot. So, Jesse's back at the table. Counting his blessings. And that's a nice shape shot. Look at this. Perfect. 8 in the corner. A clean sweep of the first 8 racks. There we go. Second round goes to doubles. So Berna breaking the balls. Comes up dry. Wade comes to the table. Misses his first shot on the stripe. Berna's back. She's taking stripes now. So she's made the stripe and has her suit. Second stripe going in, disturbing the 9 ball. Just missed the end. So Wade's coming to the table. 3 ball combo. 2 up to the 3, onto the 6. Looks like he's playing a safety here. Here, just developing his ball and leaving Berna in a safe position. She tried the kick shot. No joy, so Wade's off and running again, I think, now. Yep, 2's in. He's disturbed these balls a little bit further. Yep. 1 in the side. 3 in the opposite side. 7. Come on, he's taking that first. Probably get the 4 after this. And then use the 3 to shape for the 8. But yeah, he wanted a little bit more. He's okay. Extreme right-hand English, and English again off the second round. Very nice shot there by Wade. And the 8 goes in. That's 9-0. Rack 10. And it's Riff Melancon with the break. His opponent, Mike Holt. Things are moving, but nothing's going down. He's come up dry. Mike shaping up to take the 10 here, coming under 3 rails. And he's going to kiss the 8 there. He wanted to follow forward a bit more. He thinks he wants to get past the line straight there, so he's having to take the 9 over the corner. Well, that's his reserve option. He's used that to disturb his one safe stripe. So It's like he's drumming straight out of this between the 3 and the 5. Yeah, that'll do. Got to finish on the 12 in the side. Yeah, this 14 is a very delicate shot. He's trying to draw with a bit of spin. Looks like he's coming across and using two rails. He's under at it. Yeah, it's no good. He's having to jump this. I think his strike was a bit low on the ball. It wasn't a great delivery, so ball in hand for Riff. Oh, a blunder. Missed his first ball. He's looking at a bank shot here by where his hand is. He's made the bank, lost the cue ball. Needed to get round by four rails there for the eighth. He was kicking, trying to kick his head. That was a good hit, so not close to the pocket, but no danger. So Riff has his chance now. All the balls are there. It's just a question of holding yourself together and keeping control of that cue ball. He is slightly out of shape actually. So play this very slowly. He's recovered nicely there. Play the sip, bit of top and left English. Look round that angle. Has he got shape here? Looks good. Yeah, follow forward, use the short rail. Slightly on the hit that. What's he going to play here? Looks like the 3 and the 1 top left hand corner. He's overcut it to left, Mike a shot at the 10. The 8, sorry. Oh, he steered that. He saw a bit of body movement. So, Riff. Bit unfortunate to be doubled up. Got the balls crossed there. Trying to play a snooker. He's slightly over on it. So Mike's coming back to the table. The second bite of the cherry with a long 8 ball for this game. And that's a better strike than the last one. There we go. That's 10 to nil. And Jeff Peckham breaking the balls, his opponent Jesse Sturm in this round. Another nice break, but he's lost the cue ball. Yeah, he got a lot of balls in again, but unfortunately the white was one of them. So Jesse's off and running, he's taking the stripes. Slightly out of shape here, he's just putting this 12 in the top right hand corner. Oh, lovely shot there. Very, very delicate little floaty shot. 10 drops. He's looking good here, Jay. Has Jesse not a lot of obstacles now? He's lost the cue ball slightly, probably was playing for the 14 there. You can play on it next shot, especially with that double kiss on the 7. That's left it perfect. Little soft cut. He's got to finish behind the 3. Oh, it's drifted all the way through, so 8 ball for the rack. Ooh, and a fraction too hard. The rail rattled. So, what's Jeff got in him here? First one down. I must say, I fancy him to get these. Yeah, 3, then 4, then 6, 7 will be the final ball, I would imagine. Just wants to make sure he doesn't finish straight up that 7. Needs an angle to get out for the 8. Oh, he's a bit flat. Oh yes, he's a bit flat on this. What's he gonna do here? Could play it in off the 8. It's a bit risky. He's just tried to stun across. He's had it to use the bridge. Oh, and he's hit it too thick and sold out the game. Lucky lad, Jesse. Lucky, lucky, lucky. 11-0. Rob with a break. Everything's moving, anything dropping? Yes, there we go. Stripe drops in. And we're just having a little look around the room. You can see the second table there. That's got the East County Pool League playing on it. At the bar in the far distance with this, where the screen is. Actually, a further two pool tables round to our left. And then we've got a few darts games here. And then our home team to our left. And meanwhile, Rob's making his way through this rack of balls. That's a nice shot. Excuse me. Slightly awkward, he's now tree-topped on his first choice. I don't know if he actually played for that one, but he had to take it in the end. It's a bit tight past the five, so they're up to the table to Brian. These are all available. He can just keep himself together, control the cue ball, that's what it's all about. Nice shape on the six. No point of contact on the cue ball, so more of a drag shot, a draw or a stub. This time he is drawing across, he's going to draw across to the opposite long rail, go out for the three. Very nice. I'd be tempted to roll that three in very delicately and play the seven in the side, but he's played this with bottom and right. As we've seen before, the table is very, very fast and he's gone much farther than he wanted. And what's worse is on that bottom rail where his cue ball was, the bottom of his cue is actually touching the wall. So he's severely hampered there. Not an easy shot. So Rob may punish him now. Got a nice angle here to come across his last stride. Yeah, a little draw on the 12 here, and he's got the 8. This is it now. Stopping the rot, preventing the whitewash. Oh, where's the cue ball? Where's the cue ball? Oh my goodness. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? Brian wins the rack. Scratch on the 8. Well, well, well. 12-0. Halty breaking against Berna Bauer.
I didn't see that. Yeah. You just hit it too hard. Okay, Michael got a break, stripe down. Looks like it was a 13 ball. Two stripes. 13 and the 12. Yeah, 10. Nope. 12, 10. Nope. 11, 9. 13 and 9. And the rack looks fairly open here as well. So 12 balls in a bad spot for stripes. Solids look good all around. Yeah. Yep. If he takes the 15, the 12 will naturally get bumped out. Looking at solids. Okay, a little bit jacked up here to shoot at the 1. Probably going to shoot at the 7. Of course, when he's looking at the 1. Come down for the 3. Makes for a flat angle, though, to shape out for the 7. Shot. And he can actually, stun up here for the 4 in the same corner. Very nicely done. So I think the 4 passes the 8 for the upper left corner. So if he's gonna, he's gonna hit with some draw here. He could follow forward and go 2 rails. But he's okay there. He's got the 5 ball now. Float forward just a little bit, shoot the 4 on the side. Yeah, it's not too much, not too high. Oh, come on, big bounce off that rail. Okay, he's a little high. He's okay, he can make it, but he's going to be... cue ball is going to be going away from the 8. Nicely done. Nice. Nice control on the cue ball there, not hitting any of the other obstacles on the table. Just take it steady. Steady. Nicely done. Mike Holt with a break and run. Nicely done.
13-0, Jesse. Jesse Sturm breaks the balls. This is rank 14. His opponent, Riff Melancon. So he's got one down. He's off and running with the stripes here. Looking pretty good. What's he got to do here? Try and break out the 11. Oh, he did.
Where's the cue ball?
Oh, goodness. Oh, what a sick bet. Whenever it scratches at that acute angle, blinding. So Riff's missed his combo. And Jesse's back at the table. So not made the most of that. To bank this corner. Well, at least he cleared the pocket, so Riff's back at the table. Everything sitting pretty, really. Once again, it's the old adage, you could keep the white on a string, you should be out here, so. Oh, what has he got here? He's drawn to the one place on the table. He can't put that in the corner. He's having to bank this. And he's not put it enough, so. Jesse gets a reprieve. He's a lucky lad, but he seems to be unhappy about something here. Oh, and he's south and he's overcut it. So come on, Chris, get a game. Not again. No, I don't believe it. Where's the cue ball? Goodness me. It's unbelievable sometimes, this game. So there we go. It's 14-0, folks. Brian really breaks the balls. He's going to get a break with them all in. Oh no, they missed dry again. So Jeff comes to the table, takes the solids. Doesn't seem to have any particular problems here. They're all pretty straightforward. Yeah, he lost the cue up there, hasn't he? Yeah, he should have had shape on the 7 and managed to hug himself behind the 9. So, surrender the table after missing that long 3. And Brian's back at the table now. Stump off the side rail, get it to the middle of the table. I think he'll have the... Let's start this. 15, 11. 11, maybe. Yeah, it looks like it. He'll have... Now the 9 offers him a chance to break out the 12. Trace of bright English. There we go. Oh, that's nice. He's got a shot straight through to the middle pocket here. Looking good. Another pocket. Another pot in the same pocket. Very delicate, this one. Nicely done. Very nice. Same sort of shot on the opposite side. Beautiful. Can he make the 8? You bet he can. There we go, folks. Brian Wroolie runs out of the table. Very nice. 15-0. It's Wayne Crow to break off in the final game of tonight's match. Of course, as you know, he's in the running for the third place MVP, so he's keen to get a clean sweep. Gives him a good old crack. And there's one in, there's two in, so he's got one of each. One solid, one strike for down there. And I think if the 9 passes in that bottom right-hand corner, he's golden. He's just got to take the stripes there for sure. Because there are 5 stripes that are all clustered together. And he can make all of those very easily in these bottom 2 pockets. And then just the 1 remaining ball, I think it's the 15 down the table. And then the 8 sitting pretty over the side pocket. So, yeah, it looks like the 13's coming next. I never like playing when the speed rack's still on the table, especially if I'm going to play it slowly. I'd always try and get that out, but Wayne's getting on with it. But with a bit of pace, it should be a big problem. Yeah, nice. A little draw shot on the 12 here. And then he'll have a shot on the 11 in the same pocket. He's just got to be a bit careful there. I think it's the 2 ball there. Just it's some sort of an obstacle getting up that final stripe in that bottom right corner before he goes down for the 15. So just takes a bit of care with that one. He's got a nice angle here. Could just play off the 1 rail. Just keep it low. Don't get too high off. Not too much of a bounce. Yeah, playing it with a bit of right-hand side also meant that the cue ball was coming into the line, or rather going directly across it. So very, very shrewd play there. And I think left-hand English here will do the trick. Not a lot of pace, just a bit of spin. And a little graze on the 5 will do nicely. It's pretty straight, and that 5's not really obstructed the 8 very much. He could just draw back here, maybe about a foot or so, maybe 18 inches would be perfect. Look at this, folks. This is it for a clean sweep of 4 racks for himself. Breaker Murray in the final game and a 16-0 win overall, securing 3rd place in the league and 3rd place as MVP. It's Wayne Crow from Double Snap.
Where's the cue ball? Where's the cue ball? Oh my goodness.
There we go. Congratulations. Well, thank you very much, folks, for tuning in. Greatly appreciated. Please share and like and tell your friends, and I look forward to seeing you all again soon.